Camelot331 here, and I got a little tidbit for you today. Something a lot of you guys don't actually know about. A lot of you probably do, maybe. I don't know how much you like me. If it's a lot, maybe you don't. I don't know. But when I left GameStop after working there for 11 years, I went to work at another giant company. A company we love to refer to as Walmart. It's a terrible damn place. If you've ever worked there, you probably know what I'm talking about. But I went to work there for about a year and a half, nearly 2 years after my GameStop venture, before the YouTube thing was a thing. And it was memorable, to say the least. And we're going to talk about that. And it ended very spicy. It ended unbelievably, actually. Probably illegally, but it's fine. No one cares. It's all good, baby. I didn't die, which, retrospectively, that's a shame. But anyways, let's get right into this dirty ass sauce. Make sure, though, you updoodle the video with a like. You subscribe if you have not, because that's kind of important. And follow me on all the stuff and didn't message me. We'll talk about past loves and loves lost and sadness. Because that's all I know. So as you know, I was at GameStop for 11 years. And sadly, it had to come to an end. It had to come to an end. Because apparently sitting at your desk as a manager to work on schedules at 8:30 a.m. before the store opens is not allowed. It constitutes a break. You're supposed to stand there and stare at the wall. It's fine. Don't worry about it. But let's start off at the point of me sitting in my car driving home, having a weird sense of relief that the journey at GameStop was over. I quickly got home, sat at my computer chair, and was like, you know what? I'm going to get on Indeed and start filling out applications and build a resume that I definitely didn't spice up at all with a few white lies. I was definitely not an astronaut, but it was fine. It was on my resume. Not really. That's illegal, maybe. I don't really know. But we got on Indeed. I applied for some places. Didn't really expect anything to come of it very fast. Before the end of the day, I had 8 interviews. 8! 8 interviews. Well, I went to these interviews. It was a very fun time. A very interesting time. You'll find out real quick when you're doing this process that just because they're hiring for a store manager or a district manager at the company you applied for, well, when you get there, it's going to be part-time minimum wage for like a bathroom cleaner guy. I don't know how it works. It's kind of weird. Oh, we're not actually hiring a manager. But that's what it said anyways. Well, a few weeks of waiting goes by and I get a call on my phone device. My phone device from our favorite place in the damn world. You already know what it is. It's Walmart. Walmart's interested in talking to you boy about a position. A position that covers several stores. And it is the Walmart. Being a district manager at Walmart. That sounds like a fun gig, right? Well, oh my gosh, how this story unfolds. I thought I was hitting it big, guys. I thought I was hitting it big. Next thing I knew, it was literally a day later and I was on a plane. I was on a big old fat plane and I flew to North Carolina. Charlotte. I flew to Charlotte, North Carolina to do my training. Which was several, it was like a week of training. And this was just the first like run of training, and then there was more. But this was like the orientation thing. So we went up there, and we had to wear Hawaiian shirts the first day. Don't ask me why. I had to wear a Hawaiian shirt. And I was an Alabama guy, so I was the only guy in boots and blue jeans. I didn't get the memo that we're supposed to dress in like dress pants and stuff, like slacks. It was fine. Who cares? Retroactively, I don't really care, but yeah. So we had to train. It was a very fun time. They gave us a giant book, and we had to go through this whole book for 8 hours a day and train for this position, and then we went out and drank and got steaks. Now, I know what you're thinking. That sounds pretty kick-ass, and it was pretty kick-ass. No jokes involved in this part. I enjoy drinking and steaks, just like any other guy around my age and around my mental state of severe depression. Steaks cure it. It's been well known and documented for years. So that's what we did. So before I knew it, I was flying back home and I was thrust deeply into the cheeks of Walmart. That was a stupid one. I should edit that one out. I was thrust into the Walmart world. I had all these stores and I had to visit all these stores and talk to store managers and get to know all these people. And the first day, I knew right away that this was not going to be fun, because Walmart associates, store managers, department managers, assistant managers, co-managers, they don't like district managers. I don't know what the hell it is. They don't like you. They want you dead. They want to punch you deeply in your face, which I experienced on a daily basis. Not literally with their fists, but more like with their words. Sometimes with their fist. It was pretty insane. So here's what the job entailed. I had to visit multiple stores a day, talk to all the associates, talk to the department managers, the assistant managers, the store managers, and go over plans of action on how to increase profit in three different categories. So that was my entire job and all the people under me's job, was to increase profit in those areas. So I had to talk to all these people about that. The store managers hated me. The assistant managers also hated me. The co-managers hated me as well, and the normal employees were the only ones that were kind of okay, a little bit. It was pretty terrible, though. But first things first, communication within these stores are non-existent, absolutely non-existent. One assistant manager will tell an associate to do one thing, and then the other assistant manager that works in a different area, or maybe works a different shift, will tell the associate the complete opposite thing, and then they'll be in trouble. Regardless of what they do. This is something that's a very big problem within Walmart currently, right now, as we speak. And I don't know what it is about assistant managers, like the old, like, white lady assistant managers, but holy hell, they were psycho. They would call me when I was asleep on a Saturday night at 9 p.m. and yell at me for no reason. I literally had a lady one time call me and said, I didn't do my job. And I was like, do you even know what my job is? And she just yelled at me. She also called me on Christmas Eve at like 8 p.m. while I was ice skating with some friends. Because real men ice skate. That's the truth. That's the actual truth. One thing that was really interesting is if you mention the word union at Walmart. Some of you guys have heard the rumor, right? If you mention the word union at Walmart, a whole damn squad will fly out there and re-educate everybody like the damn cult. The union will do nothing for you. The only thing the union will do is make you pay money, and they'll do absolutely nothing. It doesn't seem worth it. That's what Walmart will tell you to make sure you don't unionize. The anti-union squad. One time I had an associate mention the word union when I was working there and visiting a store. Management ran up to this associate and started yelling at her. And she had to be like, I didn't mean union. I meant family reunion. And I had to, like, explain to the manager that that's what she meant so the manager wouldn't fire everybody on the damn spot. And for some reason, assistant managers thought they could fire me even though they were under me. It was really weird. Walmart's weird as hell, man. It's weird as hell. The anti-union squad. A small tidbit on the side. One thing I can say about this job, working at this capacity, is it was the most stressful, unbelievable job I've ever had. It was more freeing than GameStop. Because I wasn't, you know, in the store. But, oh my God. I literally could not sleep at night. Because it never stopped. Even when you took a vacation, I would get 100 calls a day from Walmart stores. And from managers, from store managers, from co-managers. And they literally were never happy. They were always yelling about something. Kind of like when you leave a review, it's usually negative. Because otherwise, you wouldn't leave a review. It's kind of like that. If they were calling me and I saw my phone ringing, I started tripping balls, man. I'm like, oh, great, I'm going to get yelled at today about some random stuff about nothing. Somebody left a cup on the desk. Everybody's getting fired today. You never got a thank you, which is fine. That's normal. Like, I don't necessarily do it for, you know, to be recognized. But you could stop yelling at me for 5 seconds. But it never ended. And all the managers were unprofessional as hell. It was just a terrible and toxic work environment. And Walmart would come up to me. Sometimes managers would come up to me and they would want me to, like, do something that was not my job title, and I would just tell them no, and they get real pissed. It was really weird, I promise. Well, it just so happens that several assistant managers and store managers, if they didn't get along with me, and trust me, I'm real easy to get along with. I'll sit in your presence and won't even talk. Ask everybody that doesn't know me. I'm very easy to get along with. But I would have store managers and assistant managers that I would have a tough conversation with because their store was struggling with numbers. So I'd be like, hey, you got to fix this. Here's how you fix it. And next thing I knew, they would call their corporate office trying to get me fired. Because I'll be like, hey, this is what you need to do. And I know, like, I was a young dude. I was, like, 28 years old. But they did not enjoy being told, I guess, what to do. Because all of them were, like, 60-year-old white people. Every damn one of them. It might be a North Alabama thing. I don't know. But they did not like me for some reason. It was kind of insane. But that's not all. That's not all. We started losing money. And I'm talking about pay in general. We got bonuses for ourselves, of course, as every body in any position ever in any company gets bonuses for their performance. Well, the company was given a pretty nice amount of bonuses every month to people that did really well. And I did really well. My district ranked number one for probably the first year I was there in sales. Well, it just so happens that bonuses slowly got taken away. Eventually, it was where your store had to beat last year's numbers by over 100% to even get the first rung of bonuses, whereas we used to just bonus off everything that was sold in the entire district. Eventually, the bonuses were taken away entirely, and they increased our salary $5,000, our base salary. So we went from making about $40,000 a year in bonuses on top of our salary to them taking it 100% away and increasing our pay by $5,000. $35,000 pay cut is pretty much what happened there. And you can imagine, almost everybody in my region quit other than me and another person, because that's a pretty big pay cut. And Walmart was making more money than ever, and they just started cutting our pay for some reason. It was actually funny. So it becomes even more stressful, because now you're not getting paid anywhere near as much as you signed on for initially. And you're getting yelled at every day. And I thought being in this district manager capacity would come with some kind of respect and chain of command. Nah, everybody was sucked. It sucked real bad. Everybody was mean to you. It didn't matter what. And I've heard this from people even in assistant manager positions and lower at Walmart. Everybody's mean as hell for no reason. And I'm just saying, old ladies. You ever met an old lady that wasn't your grandma that wasn't mean? No. If you work in retail, old ladies are mean. Now, imagine that you have a team of old ladies as your underling managers. They want you dead. So I decided to start my YouTube channel, guys. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna do YouTube, and I'm gonna make videos for fun about me talking about my work experiences and other experiences. And I did that, and I did the Walmart gig at the same time. Well, YouTube, as you know, started getting more traction because I'm a crazy person. And I started to care less about the Walmart gig because it was just getting worse. They were taking away more pay, making us work more hours. My regional director actually told me that we are not going to require you to work 7 days a week. But if you want to be successful, the people that are ranking number one in this company, they're working 7 days a week. So you probably should do that. They actually told us to work 7 days a week. Like, no joke. Be in stores 7 days a week. So the YouTube takes off, and suddenly all my employees and everybody in these Walmart stores start saying, hey, so I've been watching your YouTube channel. And I knew right then that if they were noticing it, something was about to drop. A domino was about to drop. So, one day my boss calls me, and he's like, hey, I found out about your YouTube channel. Now, he wasn't actually supposed to do this, but my boss was like this redneck dude. He was like this real redneck regional director guy that was really unprofessional. And he was like, hey, man, I found out about your YouTube, and this could be a problem. Because I was talking about, you know, GameStop and other companies here and there. And a company is not going to want me working for them if I talk bad about them. Well, it just so happens, guys. This is something a lot of people don't know. My old district manager, he actually called the corporate office for Walmart telling them about my YouTube. Because GameStop was really angry at me. My old DM was trying to damn sue me. All kinds of things was going on at the time. So he called my corporate office. My corporate office calls my regional director and says, hey, this guy's YouTube channel, here it is. So, he calls me. He wasn't actually supposed to do that. Well, HR sets up a meeting with me and my regional director about my YouTube channel. About my damn YouTube channel. I was at 37K subs when this happened. And they were like, hey, so we found out about your YouTube channel. And I'm like, yeah, I figured as much. And I remember telling people on a stream or something that they found my YouTube channel, rest in peace. And 4 days later, I had this meeting with HR. It did not take a few minutes for them to tell me that me talking to the media or anything in any capacity about anything ever would result in a termination. And they fired me right there on the spot. So my Walmart days was over. My Walmart days was over in an instant. And I'll be honest, I couldn't have been happier because that job started out being terrible, but the pay was pretty good. And then the pay got bad and the job got worse. And they wanted you to work 7 days a week. They didn't respect you at all. They were terrible. That's fine. That's fine. I get it. It's a job. That's usually how it is, especially in retail. But oh my gosh, Walmart's communication and chain of command is non-existent. Absolutely non-existent. It is an absolute nightmare. So yeah, GameStop got me fired. A lot of you might have known that because I did talk about that briefly. I said they got me fired from my current job. I never told people what that job actually was. So if you're thinking about working at Walmart, don't do it. Don't do it. Be a stripper instead. A lot less stress. All you gotta do is take your pee out and show it to people for money. That's what I do now. Subscribe to my OnlyFans right now. Camelot's Gooch is the name. I'll send you Gooch pics. I'll even sign the picture with my Gooch. I'll put the Sharpie in my brain. This is a dumb video. Look, it's about Walmart. Walmart sucks. How long is this video? I don't know. Why are you still here? Have you liked it at least? Did you at least like the video? Please, did you subscribe to me? Please. That's why we're all here, baby. That's why we're all here. It's very important. Don't work at Walmart. Who? Until next time, follow me on Instagram and Twitter. And make sure you get the hell on it, diggity doggone it. Bye. These came in the mail from my P.O. box. Thank you so much. Yeah. Delicious. I'm going to die from drinking too many of these. But it's better than the alternative, which is being alive.